a hard plastic, almost like a dog collar, a big dog collar. So the patient cannot turn their head side to side or will restrict their head from going side to side. They also put a blanket over there because we're breaking the glass now. We want to make sure that the glass doesn't get into people's eyes. And we'll actually explain to someone in a car, it's going to be a little loud, or it could be a little loud. There's going to be some noise, and we try to explain exactly what's going on. The other thing is, while all of this is occurring, the first aiders and the fire department members will be assessing or looking at the patient, trying to figure out exactly what the injury is. Are they hurt on the legs? Are they hurt on the arms? Is there any obvious injuries, or are they hidden? Do we have to ask questions? Is the person awake, or is the person sleeping and unconscious? So we really have to think of a couple things all at the same time. Now we have two tools in use, actually three there, but we have two tools in use. The one tool being used on the door is called the jaws of life, the spreaders. The one tool that just got placed on the ground is called the cutters. So there's a cutter and there's a spreader. We're using the jaws of life spreaders, and we're using that to actually pry the door, the driver's side door, away from the rest of the car. Meanwhile, in the back, if you can see in the back, Firefighter Fuller is using what's called the cutters, the O cutters. And they're in the shape of a giant O, and they're designed to grab metal and cut it. And that's Firefighter Phil Rios, who's now using it. And if you noticed, the tool, when he starts using the tool, it just moves on its own. So this is where it can become dangerous for us, when we start actually using the tools. Because they're hydraulic and they are very powerful, we have to be careful that we don't get caught between the tool and the car itself. several times over the course of my career, we got into actually taking someone out of the vehicle and got hung up on the seatbelt. And that was a result of the car being upside down and someone actually being suspended in the seatbelt. So we also have to take into account if we cut the seatbelt, then the person's just going to fall to the ground. So there's all sorts of things that we look at. Assessment working all the way around and make sure everybody knows what's going on. So again, we don't want to cause anybody to get hurt worse.
Thank you.
That's what I was talking about. They just got to make sure that a little piece of plastic, you make it very difficult. You think you get completed putt, and then when you go to do a lift like that, okay, one, two, three, let's go. It doesn't happen right away.
How's that? A round of applause.
Woo! Thanks, guys. And the first aid squad, so you know, they're here volunteering their time. They can always, if you live in town and you're looking for a worthwhile cause and you have the time, they can always use volunteers.